Hello and welcome back to GameSpot's coverage of E3 2014. I'm your host, Danny O'Dwyer. Delighted to be joined by the gentlemen from Arrowhead Games, Patrick and Johan. Nice to see you here.
Nice to see you.
Pleasure.
Nice to see you.
Gentlemen, you are here with Helldivers. This is a game that's coming out later this year on PS3, PS4, and PlayStation Vita. You've been shopping it for a while now. For the folks who've never seen it before, explain the overall grand concept of what Helldivers is.
You want to take it?
Yeah, sure.
Go for it.
So Helldivers is a fairly hardcore, top-down, four-player, cooperative twin-stick shooter, I'd call it. You are four elite soldiers, and you do missions for the Super Earth government to liberate humanity from the evil threats of the universe.
I've played a lot of games like Alien Breed. I was really into when I was younger, and then they brought all the new Alien Breeds out on the consoles last generation. This is on a purely like physical level. That's what I'm touching into when I see this. What is it that makes Helldivers different in relation to all those other games? Because it's quite that space got a little bit crowded there a while ago.
I mean, for one, with all games that we make, we want to do a play on not just the core mechanics of the game, but the way that the players interact while in the comfort of their home. So Helldivers always has friendly fire on.
Awesome.
It has a unique mechanic, which is called the stratagems, which you can call down from orbit at any time. So basically, you just hit a button, input a combination, and you can get airstrikes, mechs, vehicles, whatever. And all of these drops confer something to the team. And, I mean, even though you call something down, it's not necessarily yours. I can grab it, or Patrick can grab it. And it creates for a really, like... what do you call it? Not hostile environment, but you know, you're kind of friendly, hit your friend on the shoulder, kind of like the brother versus brother scenario.
Yeah, I took my gun.
Yeah. You jerk. I like the lack of friendly fire is an interesting one, especially when you're playing with four people on these types of scenarios where often you're trying to cover each other from multiple directions.
Yeah, and it really does work well in Helldivers. Because you really need to be careful what's on the other side of what you're shooting at. Since, I mean, the entire core philosophy behind the design is that you're humans. Humans are squishy.
humans are squishy.
If you have a huge crustacean with a huge claw snipping at you, you're going to lose an arm and another arm and a head. And that's usually a pretty fatal outcome for the standard-sized human. So mankind needs something to be able to counter these huge aliens or machines or whatever it is. And therefore they have extremely powerful weapons that can bring these guys down. But what happens when you apply these really powerful weapons on other humans is some kind of general slaughter.
Okay.
Squish.
Way worse.
Yes, it's way worse than...
we're looking at some gameplay here. Could you just explain the moment-to-moment action? Because I feel like that's sort of what the crux of a game like this is.
Yeah. So the guys here, they've just completed one objective, and they're going to move on to the next one. They're up against the cyborgs. They need to capture another area and activate and defend two launch pads, which are basically nukes that they need to launch on the enemy. So the Helldiver universe sort of is a weird one in the sense that we accept the illogical ways that sci-fi is portrayed. So, I mean, every mission ends with an extraction. And to bring people back from when they've fallen in combat, you cast another stratagem, which is a reinforced one, and you drop down from orbit.
Okay.
So when you get to the extraction, I mean, if you want to make a full extraction, you just call in the new guy, and he drops down from orbit, and he gets into the shuttle. And you get more points for that. So, I mean, it makes no sense from a logical perspective.
Video games.
We embrace that. Yeah.
I mean, I see one of the characters was in a mech suit or something like that?
Yes, so that was a weird sort of design decision. We were fairly late in development. We were like, wouldn't it be really cool if we had vehicles in the game? And that's what we did. It just happened. So you can actually get your hands on vehicles, like the mech, and we have some unannounced ones as well. And they sort of change the dynamic of the game in a way. I mean, they are extremely much more resilient. They are at a fixed speed, and they can traverse difficult terrain as well, which is a big part of the game, since the environment environments play a key role, and vehicles sort of allows you to traverse snow, water, and stuff like that in ways that the regular players won't.
Couldn't do it. Dwight on Twitch or on Twitter is asking: is there a different? Are you traveling from planet to planet? Is there an exploration aspect of it, or is it very much like instances where you're going in as four people?
So you're fighting a galactic war with everyone on this planet Earth, the real one, and you will travel to different sectors in the universe and further the war effort by fighting on different planets. And there are a couple of different environments and. Different races that you're fighting, and each planet, when it's completed, will advance the effort of the Galactic War. So the missions themselves are fairly closed systems, but you are always contributing to the main war effort.
Dude, specific levels that have specific types of terrain, as it were, do they have different enemies within those as well?
Yeah, so what happens is when you go into the game, you get to select sort of which war front am I fighting on. Mm-hmm. So you got the bugs, you got the cyborgs, and then we have a yet unannounced enemy species. So you select which one of those you want to fight. You go into the bugs, and then there's the region that you want to fight, and which is sort of the active region where the front line of the war is. And that's where every player in the world plays in the same region. Mm. So when I go into that region, I select one of the planets available there. So I get selected for me, like a chosen for me, like a variety of planets. It might be like a snow planet, a desert planet, or a forest planet. And these have like varying difficulties and also a strategy and reward attached to them. So you select a mission based on sort of like difficulty and reward, and also environment, of course. So the snow levels are slightly more challenging. Desert ones are sort of the medium. Forests are simpler versus certain races are more more challenging towards others. So when you've done that, you are presented with a couple of missions per planet, and these can vary from 2 to 5 missions. And when you completed all of those missions, your planet is completed, and that's then booked to the galactic backend, saying that I've done this, and the your influence, or well, mankind's, every player in the world's influence over that region is slightly increased. And on the same side, I mean, that would be a pretty one-way war if only mankind was able to take regions. So every 30 hours or so, we haven't tweaked this exactly in the best way yet, the enemy is pushed back.
Excellent.
So an event starts, which is you got to defend New York or something like that. And so that event is open for like 2 hours, and everybody just needs to get in and complete as many missions as possible. And a higher mission, a higher difficulty mission is going to give a greater reward.
Excellent.
But it's going to... I mean, the chances of failing are bigger, and it's just about completing a set limit of missions.
That's cool. It's a
mission point.
Very connected sort of experience, it seems to be. So to that end, is it very much you are logging in as one person and then playing with three other random people, or are you going to have some sort of couch cooperative type thing?
Yeah, we've got both of those. So, I mean, it's got cross-play, so you can play. I mean, the game's going to be available on PS4, PS3, and PS Vita. Mm. So if you got a Vita and a friend got a PS4, you can just come over to his place and play on your Vita with him on his PS4, or with PS3 on with PS4 or whatever. I mean, any combination you can think of. I mean, the game supports both local and online co-op.
Excellent.
So... and the way this works is that we're basically matchmaking people together based on sort of their rank and their sort of standing. So you're going to be matched with people sort of in the same level as you are. And you can further enhance this by, while in game, use a special stratagem that sort of increases your matchmaking ranking or matchmaking priority. So the likeliness of other people joining your game is even higher. And of course, for those people that just want to play single player or just want to play locally with just one other guy, there's a way to set the privacy modes for the game as well.
Awesome. John and Patrick, thank you so much for coming on and showing us Helldivers. For the folks at home, when is it coming out, and again, on what platforms?
Yeah. It's coming out this year. and we're very this
year.
Exciting. Yeah,
This year.
I almost promise.
Okay. Awesome. Thanks so much for having us on, guys. Enjoy the rest of your E3. We'll be back on the